Hey, this is Ken with PathwaysDojo.com and it...
Quiet.
Hi, this is Mark Fremke with Ninja Training TV. If you like this video, it's part of our new blog series at PathwaysDojo.com. And if you want to read more about the description, check out the link below and it'll bring you right there.
Hey, this is Ken with PathwaysDojo.com and NinjasInNature.com. This is part two of a series on tips for bow drilling. In the second part, we're going to show you techniques for how to physically put it all together, tips for how to move your arms, and how to place your body when you're setting it all up. If you don't have our free fire video yet, go to our website and you can download it for free. In it, we teach you how to make a bow drill kit, how to do tender bundles, feather sticks, a lot of the basics. This is the follow-up to the bow drill kit, where I'm going to teach you some of the tips and techniques that'll help you get a fire successfully. All right, let's talk about body positioning. So there's a lot to having your body set up just right so it's easy for you and easy to get the bow drill going. So I like to use my wrist and turn it at an angle for holding my spindle. I'm going to change the camera angle here in a second down lower so you can see it, but basically I'm going to use this angle between my forearm and my thumb as a lock that's going to go on the front of my shin. And what you really want to do is make sure your handhold is not moving. If as soon as your handhold starts wobbling a little bit, your spindle's going to wobble and it's going to go poosh and go flying off. So you want to prevent that. So one way to do that is make sure your handhold is really solid. Sometimes I'll help people if I see they're doing it, the bowing correctly, I might help steady their hand. So you can help somebody with this, but if you're doing it by yourself, you want to make sure your wrist is locked into the lower part of your shin. Okay, let's talk about the dreaded squeaky sound. It's not dreaded, but it's kind of fun to hear, but it's super high-pitched. You'll be waking up neighborhood babies, they'll start crying, all the wildlife will run away from you, so ideally you don't want to have the squeaky, dreaded sound happening, but what that basically means when you hear it is that you're starting to polish the bottom of your spindle and you're polishing the bottom of your fireboard. And so what it usually means is you don't have enough friction happening and it's just spinning and polishing. So the two things that you can do for that are speed up a little bit, but especially a little more downward pressure. You gotta get a feel for it, because if you put too much downward pressure, everything's just gonna seize up on you. So if you hear it, think about that. Stop if you just can't get it to stop, and scrape things off like we already described. I'll see if I can intentionally get it to happen here in a second. Okay, let's say you got everything together while we're talking about rope tension, and it does start to slip. You're bowing back and forth and you see that the rope is just slipping and the spindle's not moving. So there's two things I will do. One is I'll choke up on it. I'll literally grab the rope where my hand's holding it on the end and I'll pull it tighter. That's one thing. The other thing I'll do sometimes is I'll take my fingers or my thumb and I'll push outward to create more tension. That's kind of like a desperation thing where I don't want to stop. I just want to keep going and I have a little ways to go. I'm getting close and I don't want to stop, so I'll just do tension that way. So there's a technique for maintaining tension while you're bowing. Okay, all right, here we are, gopher view. I'm gonna give you an angle and perspective so you can see how it's set up on the ground, some tips for that too. So first of all, I play around, I look for a place where it's not gonna wobble. If I got a rock in here, one, your ash is gonna be flying all over the place and it's not gonna be stable and your spindle will fall out. Sometimes I take a bandana or some leaves if it's an unstable ground with a lot of rocks, and I'll literally just cushion it so it's nice and secure. This is pretty good here. It's a slight angle, but that's okay. I got my leaf that I'm gonna use as a cold catcher. This is a green leaf, so that's good, so it hopefully won't burn. Now, I'm gonna place my foot really close to the hole that I'm burning. A lot of times I like to do it barefoot even, because I can get even closer and I can even grip the board a little better. And plus I don't melt my shoes. Sometimes I'll end up staining the arch of my foot kind of yellow, like a smoker's upper lip, but that's okay. It's kind of a badge of honor. But anyway, I'm gonna put my foot right on top of the fireboard, and let me turn this way so you can see how close I'm getting. I've got my arch of my foot over the board right here, and the spindle is right next to it. And the reason I like to do that put my spindle on is so that I can get my wrist bent and locked right next to my shin and right on top of that. So my wrist is really locked in here tight. It's not going to wobble much at all. And that's really important. Let me change my angle here a little bit so you can see. Now the second thing I'm going to do is I'm going to practice just using the entire bow end to end. Okay? Oh, there's that little squeak. I'm just starting, so I can burn through that hopefully. But I'm going to do end to end, and I like to tell people about tickling the grass. You know, I don't want to be letting the bow rise up much on either end, because what will happen is the string will rise up and then I'll get a rope burn. It'll stop. I'll have to quit and start over. You can pull it back down. If you see the rope starting to move back up, just be aware. Bring it down lower and pull it down. But try to go end to end, full length of the bow, back and forth the whole way, tickling the grass, making sure you got smooth technique. I like to start off really slow and smooth, get everything just right, and to make sure I've tuned everything up just right. If I don't have it tuned up, stop, do some wood carving, get your knife out, work on your spindle, work on your hole, get everything just right. And then once it feels like it's just right, it's going well, then you can start getting into it. Okay, so there's some techniques for how to position your body, how to hold the bow drill, how to move it. In the third part of the series, we're going to put it all together. We had the first part of the series where we talked about tuning up your kit. This part right here, we talked about how to move your body and hold your body. In the final part, we're going to put it all together. We're going to try to make a fire, and we'll also show you some common mistakes that people make. So check out the third part.